Good morning and Happy New Year, everyone! Welcome back again to our Valenzuela Live Mathematics for Grade 5. I am Christopher M. Saremo, your EdLive teacher for today. Before we proceed on our discussion, kindly do the following so that your class discussion teacher would recognize your attendance. Okay, so type in your complete name, your subject teacher, and your school in the comment box. For example, Carmel B. Balane, Sir Jeffrey S. Lozano, Pasadena Blas Elementary School. Second, if you have queries or question regarding on our topic, just write your question in the comment box below. And then lastly, if you want to answer, just type in your answer on the comment box. Before we proceed on our discussion, let's identify the learning competencies. So we are now on our quarter 2, week 3 of our most essential learning competencies. And for today's lesson, you should be able to learn, solve routine and non-routine problems involving addition and subtraction of decimal numbers, including many, using appropriate problem-solving strategies and tools. Let's have some exercises. So I want you to solve the following problems are given. So the first one is, what is the sum of 23,560,000 plus 15,258,000? I will give you 15 seconds and your timer starts now. Okay, time's up. So let's check your work. Remember last time, Teacher Beron discussed on how to add and subtract decimal numbers. So do you still remember what Ma'am Beron discussed to you? Great job, great by pupils. So the first thing you're going to do is to align the decimal numbers into column. And then make sure that the two decimal points are aligned also. And then add or subtract as if you are adding or subtracting whole numbers. So let's check. So 0 plus 8, the answer is 8. 6 plus 5 is 11. And then the group 1, 1 plus 5 plus 2, the answer is 8. And then bring down the decimal point, 3 plus 5, the answer is 8. And then 2 plus 1 is 3. So our final answer now would be 38,818,000. If your answer on the comment box is the same, good job, grade 5 pupils. Next, add 5,560,000 and 3,213,000. Your 15 seconds starts now. Alright, time's up. So let us check our work. We have 5,560,000 plus 3,213,000. So again, write the decimal numbers into column. Make sure that the decimal points are aligned. And then add as if you are adding whole numbers. So 0 plus 3 will give us an answer of 3. 6 plus 1 is 7. 5 plus 2 is 7. Good job, grade 5 pupils. And then bring down the decimal point, and then 5 plus 3 is 8. So our answer is 8,773,000. Next, subtract 34,67 from 57,20. Your 15 seconds starts now. Alright, time's up. So we need to subtract. So 57,20 minus 34,67. So 0 minus 7, cannot be. So we need to regroup 2, and 2 becomes 1, and 0 becomes 10. So 10 minus 7 is 3. And then 1 minus 6 cannot be. So we need to regroup from 7. 7 becomes 6, and 1 becomes 11. So 11 minus 6, the answer is 5. And then bring down the decimal point. And then 6 minus 4 is 2. And then 5 minus 3 now would be 2. So our answer is 22 and 53 hundredths. Excellent job, grade 5 pupils. Next, for the fourth number, what is the difference of 62 and 7 tenths less 23 and 45 hundredths? Your 15 seconds starts now. All right, let's check. So 62 and 70 hundredths. Remember, class, we have equal decimals. So the equivalent decimals of 62 and 7 tenths is 62 and 70 hundredths. And then subtract 23 and 45 hundredths. So 0 minus 5 cannot be. We need to regroup from 7. 7 becomes 6. And then 0 becomes 10. So 10 minus 5 is 5. And then 6 minus 4 is 2. And then bring down the decimal point, 2 minus 3. Can we subtract 2 minus 3? Okay, good. We cannot subtract. So we need to regroup from 6. 6 becomes 5. And then 2 becomes 12. So 12 minus 3 will give us an answer of 9. And then 5 minus 2 is 3. So our answer now would be 39 and 25 hundredths. Do you understand, grade 5 pupils? Good job. Okay, for the last number, we have add 5 and 45 hundredths to the difference of 3 and 40 hundredths and 1 and 75 hundredths. Your 15 seconds starts now. Okay, so what are the things you are going to do first? So we need to add or subtract. Okay, the things you are going to do first is to find the difference. So the difference of 3 and 40 hundredths and 1 and 75 hundredths. So 0 minus 5 cannot be. So we need to regroup from 4. So 4 becomes 3. And 0 becomes 10. So 10 minus 5. Great job, grade 5 pupils. So the answer is 5. 3 minus 7. Okay, we need to regroup. So 3 becomes 2. And 3 becomes 13. So 13 minus 7 will give us an answer of 6. Bring down the decimal point. And then 2 minus 1 now would be 1. And then after we get the difference, we need to add 1 and 65 hundredths to 5 and 45 hundredths to get the sum or to get the final answer. So 1 and 65 hundredths plus 5 and 45 hundredths. So 5 plus 5, 10, regroup 1. So 1 plus 6 is 7, 7 plus 4 is 11, and then regroup 1, and then bring down the decimal point. So 1 plus 1 plus 5 will give us an answer of 7. So our final answer now would be 7 and 10 hundredths. Okay, since you already know or master how to add and subtract decimal numbers, let us apply it in solving word problems. Are you ready? If you are ready, good job, grade 5 pupils. Okay, in solving word problem, We need to understand the problem first. Know the information asked, know the given facts, and then look for the keyword. That is the three important elements on understanding the problem. Again, know the information asked, know the given facts, and look for the keyword. And then, make a plan. After you understand the problem, you need to make a plan. So, determine the operation to be used and write the number sentence. And then lastly, carry out the plan. That is the time that you're going to solve or find the answer. Okay, so let's apply all the steps in problem solving in the given problem. So the first problem now would be, Carmel had 368 pesos and 25 cents. Her mother gave her 253 pesos and 50 cents. How much money does she have in all? So the first thing we're going to do is, great job, grade 5 UPS, to understand and identify what is asked on the problem. What is asked in the problem? All right, the total amount of money Carmel has. And then after you identify, what's next? Very good, grade 5 UPS. You need to identify the given facts. And the given facts are 368 pesos and 25 cents and 253 pesos and 50 cents. Then, identify or plan what is the operation to be used. So, the operation to be used is addition. And then, after we identify the addition with our pupils, we need to write the number sentence. So, the number sentence now is N is equal to 368 pesos and 25 cents plus 253 pesos and 50 cents, where N is the total amount of money Carmel has. Do you understand? All right. And then, after we understand, we plan. Now, let's proceed on solving the problem. So, 368 and 25 cents plus 253 pesos and 50 cents. Again, write it in column and then make sure that the two decimal points are aligned. And then proceed as if we are adding whole numbers. So, 5 plus 0, very good. The answer is 5. 2 plus 5, 7. And then, bring down the decimal point. 8 plus 3, 11. Regroup 1. So, 1 plus 6, the answer is 7. Plus 5, the answer is 12. We need to regroup 1 again. So, 1 plus 3 plus 2 will give us an answer of 6. So, therefore, 621 pesos and 75 cents is the total money of Carmel. Okay, now let's proceed on the second example of grade 5 pupils. Lucy wants to buy a pair of shoes that costs 854 pesos and 75 cents. If she was able to save 578 pesos and 25 cents for it, how much more does she need? So remember, it is very important to save money, especially today. We are in the pandemic. So saving money would help a lot. So grade 5 pupils, I hope that you save money from your allowances. Okay. Understand what is us? The amount of money she still need to buy a pair of shoes. Next, understand what are the given facts. So the given facts are, very good, 854 pesos and 75 cents and 578 pesos and 25 cents. And then, identify now the operation to be used. So that is subtraction. And then, write the number sentence. Can you identify the number sentence? You may type in your answer in the comment box. Let's see what is the correct number sentence. So the number sentence now would be N is equal to 854 pesos and 75 cents minus 578 pesos and 25 cents, where N is the amount of money she still need to buy a pair of shoes. After we identify the number sentence, let's proceed on solving the problem. So 854 pesos and 75 cents minus 578 pesos and 25 cents. So again, make sure that the decimal numbers are aligned and the decimal point is aligned also. And then proceed in subtracting decimal numbers. So 5 minus 5 is 0. Very good. 7 minus 2, the answer is, great job, the answer is 5. Bring down the decimal point. Can we subtract 4 minus 8? Alright, we cannot subtract. So we need to regroup. 5 becomes 4 and 4 becomes 14. And then 14 minus 8 is 6. 4 minus 7. Alright, we need to regroup. So 8 becomes 7 and 4 becomes 14. 14 minus 7 now would be 7. And then 7 minus 5 is 2. So therefore, our answer is 276 pesos and 50 cents is Lucy needs to buy a pair of shoes. So the amount of money she need to buy a pair of shoes. Okay. Next problem. After earning an interest of 193 pesos and 72 cents, Mabel's saving account balance is 6,651 pesos and 6 cents. What was her saving account balance before earning the interest? Again, grade 5 pupils. So we need to identify what is asked. So Mabel's savings account balance before earning the interest. After we identify, what's next? Alright, we need to find the given facts. So we have 6,651 pesos and 6 cents and the interest, which is 193 pesos and 72 cents. And then write it in or identify the operation to be used. So we have subtraction. And then let's put it in the number sentence. So the number sentence now would be N is equal to 6,651 pesos and 6 cents minus 193 pesos and 72 cents. And then, where N is Mabel's savings account balance before earning the interest. And then now, solve. So, 6,651 pesos and 6 cents minus 193 pesos and 72 cents. So, 6 minus 2 will give us an answer of 4. And then, 0 minus 7 cannot be. So, we need to regroup from 1. 1 becomes 0 and 0 becomes 10. 10 minus 7 is 3. Bring down the decimal point. And then 0 minus 3 cannot be again. So, we need to regroup from 5. So, 5 becomes 4 and 0 becomes 10. 10 minus 3 is 7. Great job, grade 5 pupils. 4 minus 9 cannot be. So, we need to regroup from 6. So, 6 becomes 5 and 4 becomes 14. 14 minus 9 is 5. And then 5 minus 1 is 4. And then bring down 6. So, our final answer now is 6,457 pesos and 34 cents is the savings account balance before the interest. Did you get it, grade 5 pupils? Excellent job! Okay, next. Tonton bought 2 kilograms of chicken worth 256 pesos and 50 cents and 1/2 kilogram of beef worth 195 pesos and 25 cents. If he gave the cashier 500 pesos, how much change did he get? So can you identify the ask on the given problem? So the given what is asked on the problem is Tom Tom's change. And then we need to find the given facts. So the given facts are 2 kilograms of chicken worth 256 pesos and 50 cents. We also have 1/2 kilogram of beef worth 195 pesos and 25 cents. And also lastly is 500 pesos. And then if we are going to identify the operation to be used, addition and subtraction. And then, what is the number sentence? So the number sentence is N is equal to 500 pesos minus open and close parenthesis 256 pesos and 50 cents plus 195 pesos and 25 cents, where N is Tonton's change from 500 pesos. And then solve. Since we have parentheses, we need to add or we need to perform first the operation inside the parentheses. So we need to add 256 pesos and 50 cents plus 195 pesos and 25 cents. So therefore, 0 plus 5 is 5. 5 plus 2 is 7. Bring down the decimal point. And then 6 plus 5 is 11. Regroup 1. So 1 plus 9 plus 5. The answer is 15. Regroup 1. So it will become 1 plus 2 plus 1. The answer now would be 4. So therefore, 451 pesos and 75 centavos is the total amount of 2 kilograms of chicken and 1/2 kilograms of beef. And then after we identify the total amount of 2 kilograms of chicken and 1/2 kilograms of beef, we need to subtract it from 500. Okay. So 500 minus 451 pesos and 75 cents. So we need to subtract 0 minus 5. Since we cannot subtract 0 minus 5, we need to regroup. So it will become now 9994. And then 0 would become 10. Then we can now proceed on subtracting subtracting the numbers. So 10 minus 5 is 5. 9 minus 7 is 2. Bring down the decimal point. 9 minus 1 is 8, and then 9 minus 5 is 4, and then 4 minus 4 is 0. So our final answer now is 48 pesos and 25 cents is the change of Tom Toms. Okay. Jeffrey bought food for his family. He ordered one whole chicken for 350 pesos. One pancit canton for 245 pesos and 50 cents. A pitcher of lemonade for 175 pesos and 50 cents. And a bowl of fruit salad for 60 pesos. How much is the total cost of the food? Okay, so identify what is asked on the problem. Okay, the total cost of the food. And then, after you identify, what are the given? So first, one whole chicken for 350 pesos. Second, one pancit canton for 245 and 50 cents. And then last, one pitcher of lemonade for 175 and 50 cents. And then lastly, a bowl of fruit salad for 60 pesos. Okay, what is the operation to be used? Of course, it's addition. This time, we are going to use a table. So, we are going to make a table. Okay. We can use table to show our solution. So, this time, we have food, and on the other column, we have cost. So, food, one whole fried chicken for 350 pesos, one pancit canton for 245 pesos and 50 cents, and then we have one pitcher of lemonade for 175 pesos and 50 cents, and then a ball of fruit salad for 60 pesos. And then, we need to find the total amount. So, if you're going to add all the numbers, the amount is 831 pesos. Great job, grade 5 pupils. If you understand, let us proceed now on some exercises. This time, you are going to answer the following problem, and then I will give you 30 seconds. If you are done, just write your answer on the comment box below, and then we are going to check. Remember, you have only 30 seconds to answer. For the first problem we have, in a sale promo, a tablet was sold at 4,462 pesos and 50 cents. If its original price was 5,250 pesos, how much less was the sale price? Your 30 seconds starts now. Okay, time's up. So let's check your work. So we have 5,250 pesos minus 4,462 pesos and 50 cents. Remember, we need to write it in column and then make sure that the two decimal points are aligned. So 0 minus 0, the answer is 0. 0 minus 5 cannot be, so we need to regroup. So it will become 4, 9, and 0 would become 10. So 10 minus 5 is 5. Bring down the decimal point. 9 minus 2, the answer is 7. And then 4 minus 6 cannot be. So we need to regroup from 2. 2 becomes 1, and 4 becomes 14. So 14 minus 6 is 8. So 1 minus 4 cannot be. So we need to regroup from 5. So, 5 becomes 4 and 1 becomes 11. So, 11 minus 4 is 7. And then, 4 minus 4 is 0. So, our final answer is 787 pesos and 50 cents. It is the less price amount. Okay. If you got it right, grade 5 pupils, just click the heart button. Ready? Go! Excellent job, grade 5 pupils. Okay, next problem. We have Pedro has 125 pesos and 50 cents while her younger sister has 95 pesos and 75 centavos. How much money do they have together? Your 30 seconds starts now. Okay, time's up. So let's check. We have 125 pesos and 50 cents plus 95 pesos and 75 cents. So we have 0 plus 5. We have 5. 5 plus 7. The answer is 12. We regroup 1. So bring down the decimal point. And then 1 plus 5 is 6. Plus 5. The answer is 11. Regroup 1. And then 1 plus 2, that is 3 plus 9, the answer is 2, the group 1. And then 1 plus 1 is 2. So therefore, our answer now would be 221 pesos and 25 cents is the total amount of money they have together. If your answer is correct, just click again the heart react on your button. Ready? Go! Very good, grade 5 pupils. Next. Norma saved 785 pesos and 75 cents. She gave 500 pesos to her mother. How much was left for her? Are you ready? If you are ready, your 30 seconds starts now. Okay, time's up. So let's check your work. You have 785 pesos and 75 cents minus 500 pesos. So again, 5 minus 0, the answer is 5. 7 minus 0, the answer is 7. Bring down the decimal point. And then 5 minus 0 is 5. And then 8 minus 0 will give us an answer, 8. And then 7 minus 5 is 2. So therefore, our answer now would be 285 pesos and 75 cents is the amount left to Norma. This time, if you got it correct, just click the like react button. Ready? Go! Very good, grade 5 pupils. Next problem. Tom went to a department store that was having a big sale and bought a beautiful dress for 750 pesos and 95 cents and a purse for 375 pesos and 50 cents. After she gave an amount to the cashier, she received a change of 373 pesos and 55 cents. How much money did she give to the cashier? Your 30 seconds starts now. Okay, time's up. So let's check your work. So we have 750 pesos and 95 cents plus 375 pesos and 50 cents. And then lastly, plus 373 pesos and 55 cents. So we are going to add all the given. So we have 5 plus 0 plus 5. The answer is 10, the group 1. And then 1 plus 9 plus 5 plus 5, our answer now would be 20, regroup 2. So 2 plus 0, 2, plus 5, 7, and then 7 plus 3 will give us an answer of 10, regroup 1. So 1 plus 5 is 6, plus 7, that is 13, and then 13 plus 7 will give us an answer of 20, and then regroup 2. So 2 plus 7, 9, 9 plus 3 is 12, and then 12 plus 3, the answer now would be 15. So therefore, 1,500 is the amount she gave to the cashier. Okay, next. For the last number, we have James and Yen Yen bought the following vegetable. Cabbage worth 62 pesos and 95 cents. Kangkong worth 25 pesos. And pechay worth 18 pesos and 25 cents. If James has only 75 pesos, how much does Yen Yen have to add to pay for the vegetables? Your 30 seconds starts now. Okay, let's check your work grade 5 pupils. For this time, 62 pesos and 95 cents plus 25 pesos plus 18 and 25 cents. So the first thing we're going to do is to add all the given primes. So we have 5 plus 0 plus 5. The answer is 10, the group 1. So 1 plus 9 is 10, plus 0 is 10. And then 10 plus 2 is 12, the group 1. And then 1 plus 2 will give us an answer of 3 plus 5. The answer is 8. And then 8 plus 8 will give us an answer of 16. And then the group 1. And then lastly, we have 1 plus 6 is 7. 7 plus 2, the answer is 9. And then 9 plus 1 is 10. So the answer first is 106 pesos and 20 cents. And then you need to subtract 106 pesos and 20 cents minus 75 pesos. Okay, so 0 minus 0 will give us an answer of 0. 2 minus 0 is 2. Bring down the decimal point. And then 6 minus 5 is 1. 0 minus 7 cannot be. So we need to regroup 1. 1 becomes 0. And then 0 becomes 10. So 10 minus 7 is 3. So therefore, 31 pesos and 20 cents is the amount of money she need to add to pay for all the vegetables. Do you understand, grade 5 pupils? Very good, grade 5 pupils. So remember, grade 5 pupils, that in solving word problems, we apply the following steps. First, understand the problem. Know the information asked. Know the given facts. And look for the keyword that indicates the process to be used. Second, make a plan. Determine the operation to be used and write the number sentence. And then after that, you need to carry out the plan. Okay. Now, we are now proceed on our question and answer portion. This time, if you have question or queries regarding on our discussion, you may type in your question in the comment box below. I will give you 15 seconds and our moderator will randomly select questions that I will answer. Your 15 seconds starts now. Okay, time's up. So the first question that I received is, what are the techniques or strategies in solving decimal and solving problems involving addition and subtraction of decimal numbers? Again, there are, grade 5 pupils, there are many ways on how to solve problem solving. So the first thing is you may follow the steps in solving word problem. First, identify the problem or understand the problem. And then make a plan, and then also carry out the plan. And then you may use different strategies like bar model, discovery method, making a table or drawing, or you may act out the plan. Is that clear, grade 5 pupils? Very good. Since we do not have enough time, some of your questions may be answered by your class discussion teacher for the next Zoom class. Okay, for your assignment, on your self-learning module, answer what I can do, an assessment on page 11. Again, on your self-learning module, answer what I can do, an assessment on page 11. Okay, grade 5 pupil, thank you for your active participation. Once again, I am Christopher M. Salemo of Paso de Blas Elementary School. Stay safe and God bless everyone. Goodbye.